What I've created here is a shift schedule that you can enter a shift by start date. Now, you probably don't have that much of a turnover of, hopefully you don't have that much of a turnover of all your staff, but if you did, you would enter their start date. And so let's say we had somebody that was starting January 7th, and we'll say his name is employee 12. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click the button, enter shifts, and I'm gonna go employee 12. And then it's gonna search for that, and then you're gonna say, he started on the 7th. Okay, and so then I'm gonna go enter date. And until I go clear form and then close it, and I'm gonna go control home to get back to my beginning. 5 days, 2 days off, 5 evenings, 2 days off, 5 nights. Now, at the bottom of your sheet, you can see I've got 2 shifts in here already, and you can see that you have 2 days, 0 evenings, 0 nights here, and so you can keep track of if you've got all the shifts covered. Now, this will repeat for the entire year, and what I've done is I've added on extra days so that if it goes over the end of the year, it will be able to see what shifts are going forward. So what I've done is I've selected each range in a drop-down list here. I've named the ranges, and so let's name December. So here we go. This is the December 2019, and you have all your shifts that are going on then. And then considering it's probably going to go over, if you had someone starting in November, it would be going over. And so I've included into January, February, and a little bit of March, just so that you can see where it's going over with your shifts. Now, I will include the code, and here you still have the totals of the days, the nights, and the evenings. I will include this code in the description of my thing. And what I've done here is I've dragged the January 1st all the way across to the end of the time that I want. And how I've put the days of the week up here is I've used VLOOKUP. Let me go to sheet number 2. I've created a table and VLOOKUP. So what we've done here in here is we've said weekday. We've looked up the weekday of this cell here, and the weekdays in Microsoft, number 1 is Sunday and number 7 is Saturday. And so using the VLOOKUP, we've included the name of the day of the week on top of the date here, so that you're able to see what you're doing with the shifts. And then of course we have I've done this by using COUNTIF. So COUNTIF, the range of cells here, and if it equals D, then it's number of days, and the same thing for evenings and nights, right? And so once again, let me show you the code. And so what I've done is I have, for the lookup box, I've used a combo box, and then I've looked if it's January, February, or March all the way down. And then it's counted the days within that. And then, so what I've done is if on the, when you've figured the active cell, and that's just the cell that you've selected choosing the month and the day. And so that's the active cell. And then I've just added, then it starts with the first active cell will be days. And then it's added 4 additional days, 2 additional days off. Then it's added 5 additional evenings, 2 days off, 5 nights, and 2 days off. Now, when I divided 20 into, because this is a shift of 20, basically, into 365, I came up with about 18. And so I did 19 to make sure we covered the whole thing. And so I'm repeating this 19 times in a year. So this is how you create a shift from the start day and how it goes. Now, when you have your shifts already in here, and you know you're looking at this, and you're playing around with the shifts so that you can get it covered, and you're thinking, ooh, this guy shouldn't be working this. And so all you do to delete this shift is you click on the cell that you want to start with, you press Control Shift, and the right facing arrow, and it goes to the end of the days, And then maybe you might want to, instead of starting on the 10th here, maybe you want to start him on the 5th. So then it's just a matter of entering your employees, go employee 2, and then we're going to start him on the 5th. Now we'll clear the form, we'll go control home to get back to where we were. And there you have your in there, and that might make change of totals on you. Now, the other thing too is that you can start, so you probably you'll have an employee starting at the middle of November, or let's say the middle of October of next year. So what you can do is you can select here, and let's say it's employee 6, and then let's choose October, and let's say he's starting on October 5th. And so then you go enter date, and then see, this is why we have it going further. You go back to let's go down to October here, and you can see that your new employee has started on October 5th. And your totals of all your different shifts are now included in that. So that's how you enter shifts, rotating shifts from a start date. Please subscribe.